don't start writing your results section until you've tried this. I always map my data before I start writing. It tells me exactly what I need to do and it makes my results section easy to write and easy to understand. First, I maintain the flow of my results section within my whole scientific report. I always write my methods section first, so I make sure that my results section follows the same order, the same logical flow as my methods section. So whatever I did first, I write about first. It takes the guesswork out of writing it because I don't have to think about what I should write next because I already know. I then add any headings or subheadings in that I need to break up my results section, and that makes it easy for the person reading and marking my scientific report. It also makes it easier later when I'm writing my discussion section. And then before I start writing, I always present my data as visual items. So I make graphs, I make figures, tables, whatever works best for that particular type of data. This does two things. One, it makes your results section easier to write because all you're really doing is explaining the graph, but also it helps you understand the data better. Sometimes you can stare at the data all day in an Excel spreadsheet and you kind of understand it, but you don't necessarily see the key points or the key findings. And then when you see an image of it, you can look at it and go, oh my gosh, that had way more X than Y. It becomes really glaringly obvious when you see it visually. And that also usually gets you more marks. You can write a results section in the scientific report without having the graphs, but there's usually always marks allocated for it. There are images that you can make where your key point isn't necessarily obvious, and usually it's just the type of graph that you chose. For example, a pie graph versus a bar graph. You want to play around with your data until you find the graph that really stands out to you and really makes it obvious what your key finding is. And again, that will make it easier for you to write in your scientific report. Once I've made those images, I move on to the actual data and the writing. First of all, I remind myself to only provide direct facts. So no interpretations. We're talking about the numbers and not what they mean. We always put the interpretations in the discussion, so we put those later on. It's also important to remember that we don't want to describe the data in multiple different ways. And that also applies to text and your images. You don't want to write the exact sentence that your graph shows. You want to convey it in a slightly different way. And you never want to repeat yourself. Then it's all about accurate details. And I do that by choosing the data type that I'm going to report up front. So I choose between averages, ranges, percentages, whatever works best for the data. I choose that before I write it. I also include any descriptive data in brackets after my original data. For example, the number of data points or the standard deviation. I can then write my sentences for each of my data points using that selected data type. Then I make sure I have thorough statistics. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean you need to use statistical treatment on your data, but if you did, you need to report it correctly. And that means reporting things like your p-value or confidence intervals. You can also do this in your descriptive data, like I said before. It may just be your standard error or your standard deviation that you're reporting. But if you use any statistics at all, then you need to report those. And then I align my formatting. I make sure that for all of my sentences in my results section, that I've been consistent with the data type that I'm reporting. For example, if I've chosen to use averages, then I make sure I've reported the average for every single data point that I want to discuss, all of my key findings. I don't switch between averages and then ranges and then percentages because that becomes confusing for the person reading it, and it's confusing when you write it, and it also makes writing your discussion really hard. So I make sure that I'm consistent all the way through with that number formatting. Remember, your results section is all about writing about the numbers and not writing about the key finding or what they mean. By keeping our results section firmly on the data, it also makes writing the discussion section easier because we're not doubling up on the things that we've already written about.